Today we will study examples and applications of refraction phenomena. Some of the examples of refraction phenomena include total internal reflection, dispersion, and among their applications and uses are fiber optics, telecommunication, endoscope, periscope, and rainbows. Before I start this topic, I would like to give a little bit more explanation about Snell's law and refractive index that we studied in the last lesson. As I have told you already that Snell's law is N1 sine theta 1 is equal to N2 sine theta 2, where N1 is refractive index of the denser medium and N2 is refractive index of the rarer medium. Now, as we know that light is refracted because it slows down or speeds up, as we have studied in our last lesson, therefore the refractive index N can also be written as a ratio of two speeds in this way. So N of from medium 1 to medium 2 is equal to speed of light in medium 1 over speed of light in medium 2, where the word medium means the substance that the light is traveling through. When the light is going from one medium to another, the refractive index is called the relative refractive index, and it will have two suffixes. For example, for light traveling from glass to water, it is written as N from glass to water. When light travels from a vacuum to another medium, the value of N is called the absolute refractive index. This has only one suffix. For example, for light traveling from a vacuum into glass, it is simply written as N glass. We will omit this vacuum word. Now, there is an example that makes use of Snell's law in terms of speed of light. The refractive index for light moving from a vacuum into air is 1.0003, and the speed of light in a vacuum is C is equal to 2.9979 into 10 raised to the power 8 meters per second. What is the speed of light in air? So we will make use of the same formula, and we will substitute the values of refractive index and speed of light in vacuum, and we get speed of light in air equal to 2.9970 into 10 raised to the power 8 meter per second, which is approximately the same as that of speed of light in vacuum. Total internal reflection. A ray of light emerging from glass into air is refracted and bends away from the normal. Like in this case, I will be less than R because it travels from a denser medium to rarer medium. And here we notice that the ray which is normal to the surface is not bent, as we have already studied in the last lesson. Anyway, some of the rays reflected back as well. Now, if we go on increasing the angle of incidence, or as I is made bigger, the refracted ray gets closer and closer to the surface of the glass. When I is equal to C, the refracted ray is just touching the glass surface, and R will be equal to 90 degrees, this one. And when a ray of light is incident from glass to air at an angle greater than the critical angle, then all of the light is reflected at the glass-air boundary. It is called internal reflection because it occurs inside the glass, and is called total because all the light must be reflected. Now, total internal reflection has uses in prisms, optical fibers, etc. And I have just here give a clear picture of the critical angle, which is the angle of incidence for which angle of refraction is 90 degree, like in this case. Dispersion. Dispersion is a phenomena in which white light is incident on a refracting surface, like in this case, there is a prism. And as we know that white light consists of 7 colors and each color has different wavelengths, so each color is deviated through a different angle. As light passes from air to glass, it is bent towards the normal, So angle of incidence will be greater than angle of refraction. Now at the second interface, when the light is again entering from a denser to rarer medium, in this case, angle of refraction will be more than angle of incidence at this junction. And we get a spectrum of 7 colors. Now, examples and applications of refraction phenomenon. Fiber optics. The optical fibers or a fiber optics consist of, I will first explain about its structure and then its working and applications. Now, an optical fiber consists of a very thin core of high purity glass. The core is covered by a second layer cladding, which is also made from high purity glass. The cladding is less dense than the core and has a lower refractive index. As for total internal reflection to occur, the light ray must travel from a denser medium to a less dense medium. Therefore, light rays passing along the core at an angle greater than the critical angle are totally internally reflected. Now, how do optical fibers work? When light from a laser enters at one end of the fiber, striking the surface of the glass at an angle greater than the critical angle, total internal reflections at the glass surface takes place and light cannot escape from it until it reaches the other end of the fiber. Now, visible light and infrared both can travel long distances in glass with very little being absorbed, and hence these both can be used. The plastic coating prevents scratches on the glass surface, which can allow the light to escape from the side of the fiber. Now, uses of optical fibers. Optical fibers carry enormous amount of information as pulses of light. Moreover, optical fibers are used extensively in the field of telecommunication. In telecommunication field, they are used as an alternative signal carrier to copper wires in the telephone system. They are used to carry digital signals in the form of light pulses over long distances. A periscope. The periscope is an instrument for observation. It consists of a tube with mirrors at each set parallel to each other at 45 degree angle, with the addition of two simple lenses, and it depends on the occurrence of regular light reflection on the plane mirrors. The periscopes are used to observe over the obstacles of between 9 and 26 meters in height. The periscope is used in the submarines to see what's going on the water surface. It was used for observation purposes in the trenches during World War I. Now, the periscope is used in the submarines to see the events which are happening behind a wall and a barrier, and some submarines use complex periscopes which make use of the prisms instead of lenses, or advanced fiber optics instead of mirrors to provide them the magnification. Complex periscopes operate on submarines in different fields of science. Rainbows. Rainbows result from refraction of sunlight in falling water droplet plus reflection of the light from the back of the droplet. These are one of the most well-known optical effects and nature's most splendid masterpieces. An excellent demonstration of dispersion of light and an evidence that light is composed of a spectrum of wavelengths, each associated with a different color. So these are water droplets. These act as prisms. So dispersion takes place when sunlight falls on this prism. This is reflection. Here refraction takes place. And white is separated into its 7 colors. Visible light is separated into 7 colors.